Just hate hiding all the time. Feeling like everybody's whispering about me.
Is that her? My mama says her whole family are Satanists.
I like you.
You don't know anything about me.
My family's different.
You a witch?
We prefer the term caster.
When I turn 16, my powers will be claimed for either the light or the dark.
You think you can keep Lena so good, so innocent? Wasn't I the same before I was claimed? And look at what I am now.
I don't know what I'll be. I have 75 days left, Ethan.
Seraphine.
The curse has already begun.
Lena will not turn dark. She's too strong.
She's going to be more powerful than either of us.
She will lead us all.
Toward what?
Mortals have run things for long enough.
Lena will put an end to them.
Seraphine is the most powerful dark caster of all.
So I'm going to be claimed for the dark no matter what?
No, you control your own nature. And loving this boy puts you in terrible danger. You'll get the both of you killed.
There's gotta be a way.
Get out! Help stop Seraphine.
Some things cannot be stopped.
It has begun.
She's already closer to the dark than I was!
I want you out of here! There's darkness in you. Don't you try and deny it. Accept it, sweetheart. Be with me.
We can rule over a new world.
Our world.
Well, the very beginning of the film, she's just trying to nurture and protect Ethan. Ethan's mother has died in an automobile accident. He and his father are just kind of recovering from that emotionally. And I made a promise to his mother that I would protect him and kind of be his co-mother. So that's how you meet me. In the book, Amma is a specific character, and then there's Marion, who is another African-American character who is a librarian. She's a PhD. She's a friend of Ethan's mother. But Amma is an older African-American woman in the book who has been Ethan's housekeeper his whole life and his father's housekeeper his whole life. But in the movie, they've combined the two characters. So I'm trying to explain who she is in the movie and not in the book. She's been redefined, which I love that she's been redefined. What I felt from him is a respect for acting and a respect for what actors do. You can absolutely see that in the casting of it with Jeremy Irons, Emma Thompson, Margot Martindale, Eileen Atkins. The list goes on and on. These are very formidable character actors from the theater. I don't think everyone casts that way.
Beautiful Creatures is really a love story between two young adults, and they fall in love. And he is a mortal boy, and she is a girl with powers, supernatural powers, and when she turns 16, it will be determined whether she is light or dark. Well, casters are either dark or light, and Ridley is naturally more dark than light, so she's a dark caster, and some of her family is dark and some are light, she's been kind of exiled by her family and forced to go into these tunnels and travel the world, and so she's become quite worldly, quite the fashionista, and quite the evildoer. I loved how kind of deliciously evil Ridley is. She's kind of your ultimate bad girl with a teeny tiny heart of gold underneath, somewhere far, far, far beneath. And she's really, really fun to play. The duality, how she manipulates people, and is she ever really being honest? It's fun.
He had a style. He has a wit. He has a bit of mystery. He has a bit of enigma. On all those things, I find attractive to play. He lives fairly remotely. He comes from a wealthy family. And owns a lot of the town that the story takes place in. And we find him having just taken on his niece, who's about to be claimed at her, in her birthday either as a light caster or a dark caster. And I am concerned that she be a light caster, in other words, a good person, in layman's language. Well, it's great that Richard Le Gravenet has written this, and so he adapted it from the book. So he knows very much what he wants. He's also very aware of films which deal in similar genre, similar subjects, and he's trying to avoid what we've seen before. I hope this will be original and hopefully quite stylish, I think. That's what he's aiming for. But it's always nice to have the writer on set because you can be quite free about the text. You can work it up until the last moment with him, and that's nice.
Let's start our lives right now.
I can't do that.
What is it? You're not telling me something. I know it. What?
It's about a young man living in a town that's hidden from the world, and into this town comes this strange young girl.
So you're not immortal. What are you then?
We prefer the term caster. The casters are sort of a higher species. You know, they're a sophisticated group of witches, but you can't call them that. They don't like it.
She did it! She broke the window!
Are you all right? They're supernaturals. They're not immortals. They're people who have powers beyond the finite abilities of most mortals.
Powers?
Yeah. Casters are either dark or light. Some of her family is dark and some are light.
And each has their own unique and special powers.
I have power over the elements, earth, air, fire, water.
Lena is a natural. Her powers are magnified.
And yet she's a teenage girl who wants to just be a normal teenage girl.
Lena, we have a guest.
I go to school with Lena. I'm Ethan White.
You have to control your emotions. Loving this boy puts you in terrible danger.
I play a character called Makin, who is a caster.
Lena will not turn dark. She's too strong.
You see the way she looks at the boy? There's no getting in between them now.
It becomes a Romeo and Juliet story and then a race against time.
That boy is a danger to you. Don't invite him here again.
No matter what they do to me, I'm still here.
These books, all the histories of the casters from around the world.
She's a keeper. I show her the sacred book because she is trying to fight her destiny.
When a female caster turns 16, we face what they call the claiming. My powers will be claimed for either the light or the dark. I don't know who I really am inside.
Lena's 16th birthday falls on the most powerful solstice in 5,000 years, and more energy will be released than ever before and transferred to her. It's a big deal.
If she becomes a dark caster, she will be the most powerful dark caster in the world, and the same for the light.
She's a girl, actually, who has an increasingly strong amount of power that she doesn't know what to do with.
I play Ridley Duquesne. She is the older cousin of Lena Duquesne.
Ridley was a great girl, but she was destined to become a bad girl.
I loved how kind of deliciously evil Ridley is. She's kind of your ultimate bad girl with a teeny tiny heart of gold underneath.
You think you can keep Lena so good?
Wasn't I the same before I was claimed? Look at what I am now.
She has a different color hair every time. She's daring in her clothing. She's very out there.
I think I found something. It's so delicious to see a fable of this kind being put together in this day and age.
I had the most amazing time making this movie.
I don't believe that we have one fate and no choice. We make our own lives.
I'm scared I'm gonna hurt you.
Go ahead.
And it has begun.